first episode. If you haven't checked it out yet, you should go back and check it out. It's about Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban and the whole thing with the time travel mechanics at the end of the book. Today we're going to be going into a more easier to understand and also very quite common for the genre time travel story. And this one is part of the short story collection of Doctor Who, 12 Doctors, 12 Stories. This is a book that I have reviewed as a whole a couple years ago, but today I'm going to be reviewing one particular story that really stood out to me using the mechanics of time travel, and that would be the Ripple Effect. The Ripple Effect is the 7th Doctor entry. So for those of you who don't watch Doctor Who, there are different Doctors. Every time he dies, he changes his appearance. So the 7th Doctor, who is played by Sylvester McCoy in the actual TV show, he has a story called The Ripple Effect, and it's by Malorie Blackman. Malorie Blackman also went on to write a Doctor Who episode called Rosa, about Rosa Parks, which became very popular over the last season with the 13th Doctor. Why this particular story stands out to me, because it, again, deals very heavily with paradoxes, going across your own timeline, and changing things based off of what results have already happened. In this case, the Doctor and his companion Ace are in the TARDIS. They're stuck in this little web thing in space called a plexus. That's what it's called. And basically, they have to get out of it. The only way they think to get out of it is by kind of ejecting themselves out using like some sort of time booster or something. I don't even remember what it was exactly, but it doesn't really matter. The point is, when they do that and they leave, they find out by landing on a planet that Daleks, you know, those little pepper pots, the bad guys, they've turned good. Like, they're actually good. Like, would you like some tea? Good. You know, building schools and being, like, vigilantes. You know, those kinds of Daleks. Which Daleks don't do that. Daleks just kill, 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 kill. That's all they do. And the 7th Doctor notices something is wrong pretty quickly. And then he realizes the universe is falling apart because something went wrong with time. And there were people who were on this planet who shouldn't be alive because the Daleks basically took over this planet. And he finds out he was actually the cause of all this change. And what happened was that when he left that plexus, he created a rupture in time, which created like a, I don't know if it was an alternate universe, alternate timeline, whatever, that basically caused this to happen, but it's unstable, and it's not supposed to be that way. And if it continues to fall apart, the entire universe would just implode, like, shoop, like that. So basically, the 7th Doctor has to make the decision that the Daleks have to be bad. That's what the universe designed them for. The universe is going to fall apart if they're not. And he goes back to the plexus and basically stops himself from doing whatever he did and does it differently so that the universe returns to normal. The interesting thing about this story is this is not only a time travel story. This is a story regarding morality. It is quite interesting how morality is kind of placed in the story. It's different from Prisoner of Azkaban. That's more like the time travel 101. This is how you write a time travel story. This is what consequences will do. But there's no moral judgment. This is more like kid friendly. This story is very much moral based. You have to decide, like, yes, Daleks are good. That's great. But the rest of the universe is in danger because it's falling apart. It's just one of those things that, do you choose the Daleks or do you choose the universe? And you kind of have to choose the Daleks. Or, excuse me, you have to choose the universe, excuse me. Because otherwise, basically you're saying, would you... It's kind of like there's another episode of Doctor Who where the Doctor finds out he causes the eruption at Pompeii. But if he doesn't cause the eruption at Pompeii, then these fire-breathing aliens will take over the world. So you have to choose Pompeii, which is about 200,000 people, I think it was, something like that, or the world, which is 6 billion people. It's never an easy choice, but you have to make it. And to involve time travel in that, it's fascinating. Because, like, what if you hated the way your grandfather was acting, and then you get the ability to time travel, and you go back in time, and you kill him? You will not be alive. That is a paradox. And so you need to understand that, like, it's not even... It's moral. It's also, like, what... You could mess up everything. Time travel is not something, apparently, to be played with. And I think both J.K. Rowling, but especially Malorie Blackman, and anyone who writes for Doctor Who, like, they get that. Time-heavy stories are the hardest stories to write. That's part of the reason I'm doing this series, because I want all of you to encourage you, because I want to encourage all of you, because time travel stories are hard to read, but this actually kind of clears it up. This particular story is actually a very good example of a well-written time travel story. Again, in time travel points, that's what I'm going to call them, in time travel points, I'm going to give this story a 5 out of 5. I think that it really, again, does an excellent job of keeping everything together. And, again, not letting things kind of drift in the wrong direction. It has a very good moral value lesson here. And so, if you do not have a copy of Doctor Who 12 Doctors 12 Stories, don't get it, and I'll explain why. Because now they have a 13th Doctor edition. 13 Doctors, 13 Stories, or something like that. They wrote an extra story for the new Doctor. You can find that copy at Barnes & Noble. This is now an old, obsolete copy. As you can see, it's kind of not in the best condition. So they now have like a 13 Doctors, 13 Stories. Definitely get into Doctor Who, because it is one of those shows that translates so well and has a great following for its novels, short stories, graphic texts. You name it, any kind of written media you will find about Doctor Who. As a matter of fact, this will not be the last Doctor Who book I will be going over in this series, but it's just the way it is written is absolutely well done almost every time. So, again, I'm Ari, and I'm signing off for Literary Gladiators, and I'll see you next time for the next episode of Time Under the Light.